Hi, everyone. Welcome to another episode of OEM TV. I'm Eric Mills with Microsoft. I do Windows Server marketing here. And in this video, you're going to get a really in-depth look at virtual machine settings, specifically the CPU settings and the memory settings within Hyper-V. So if you've created a virtual machine with Hyper-V before, you know there are a lot of settings that you can customize to set that virtual machine up exactly how you want it. And it's fine to accept the defaults, but if you really want to get maximum performance and utilization from your server, then you want to dig into those a little bit. So in this video, Paul has set up four different virtual machines. So there's a web front end, there's a middle application tier, there's a database tier, and an Active Directory tier. So four different virtual machines. And he's going to use Hyper-V Manager to modify the CPU and memory settings. So you'll get to see what dynamic memory looks like. He'll talk about the memory buffer and the memory weight and the virtual CPUs and how many you can assign and how many you should assign. He'll also talk about with each of those four different virtual machines, how might you want to assign the memory and CPU to get maximum utilization out of the entire stack, from the front end all the way to the back end. So if you set up a lot of virtual machines for application servers, or if you really just wanted to know the details of how the CPU and memory settings within the virtual machines are going to affect your overall performance, you're going to love this video. I hope you enjoy it. We'll see you next time on OEM TV.
Thank you, Eric. And hello, everybody. In this video, we're going to look at some of the settings in Hyper-V that can affect your overall system. So there's memory settings and there's CPU settings that we'll be looking at. And we'll roughly apply them to a real-world situation. First, an explanation of what we're looking at here. What we've got is Hyper-V Manager on Windows Server 2016, and then we've also got Resource Monitor. And in the Hyper-V Manager, we've got several servers. So there's a web front end, there's a middle tier, the database tier, and then Active Directory. So this would be a three-tier model, standard three-tier model with a directory for authentication in case you want to do registrations and those types of things. Okay, let's look at Active Directory first, and let's look at the settings. And there are two major areas that we want to focus on in this video, because it's kind of a short video, is memory and then processors. So for memory, one of the first things is, and this happens when you're setting up your virtual machine, it asks if you want to enable dynamic memory. So dynamic memory is just the ability of the system to regulate the amount of memory that the virtual machine gets. So if it needs more memory from its basic starting point, then it can obviously get that memory via dynamic memory. And between multiple virtual machines, the system moderates the memory allotment to each virtual machine depending upon the activity that creates demand for that virtual machine as it's more heavily used. So I've got dynamic memory enabled here, and I've also got this startup memory. So it says specify the amount of memory that this virtual machine can use. Well, this really is a startup amount, because if you've enabled dynamic memory, then you can set minimums and maximums as well. So then there's this memory buffer, and this says specify the percentage of memory that Hyper-V should try to reserve as a buffer. Hyper-V uses the percentage in the current demand for memory to determine an amount of memory for the buffer. By default, they're all set at 20%. And then there's also this memory weight, and memory weight is basically you specify how to prioritize the availability of memory for this virtual machine compared to the other virtual machines on this computer. So let's look at our environment here. So we got a web front end, a middle tier, database, and Active Directory. Now of these, which one would need the most memory, or which one would have to have the highest relative weight of accessing memory? Well, if we kind of look at it, a web front end, if you're using IIS and the data is cached, you know, it's basically cached in memory, well, that might need a higher amount of memory or a higher reserve or even a higher priority of accessing memory. Because what if you start getting a lot of hits really quickly? And then the middle tier is probably, you know, it's the application tier, if you will. So it might need a lot of memory, but it also might need the dominant amount of CPU, because those applications are probably thick to some degree or heavy. And yeah, they probably require memory, but they also need a lot of CPU to execute them. And then the database, well, databases need, we know they need IOPS for sure to get to the disk, but they also need CPU and they also need memory. But Active Directory, I mean, what does it do? It basically would authenticate requests. So let's say it's a website where people have to log in and register to get something, maybe a downloaded white paper or something along those lines. I mean, a lot of this varies. It depends on what the website's about, what the environment's about. But these are just some kind of guidelines on how to adjust these settings. So Active Directory in general probably wouldn't need a lot of CPU. It probably wouldn't need a lot of memory either. And quite frankly, it probably wouldn't need a lot of disk, because if it's only doing authentications, then authentications are really lightweight. They're basically a request to authenticate and then a response. So there's not a lot going on with them. Now, that said, if you've got a lot of policies in Active Directory, that could change it as well. So if the system has to look up a lot of policies based on their authentication or based on their logon, then that could get more demanding. But if it's just in a website environment where it's just used for authentication, say of users that are logging into that website, then it probably wouldn't need a lot. So how does that translate into the settings here for memory? We want it to start up quickly because it's one of those pieces of the architecture that really needs to be on first, because the other servers are going to have applications that will probably need to authenticate against Active Directory. So your startup RAM may want to be high to some degree. So let's just give this 5 gigabytes, and we've enabled dynamic memory, but the maximum amount of memory, we don't want it to be able to take everything, right? So let's just say what its maximum is going to be. So let's say its maximum is now 8 gigabytes. And then in terms of memory buffer, how much memory should you put aside? How likely is there going to be a run on authentications or a run on the Active Directory? And it's probably not very often. So I'm going to set this back down to like 5%. And then in terms of memory weight or prioritization, I'm going to set this a little bit lower, because we've got systems like the web front end and the database that are probably going to be at a higher priority for the buffer and the memory weight. Let's just go ahead and apply that. And then in terms of processors, so we've given this 2 virtual processors, and I think that's probably enough. They're fairly fast. And then we start getting into this resource control, where you can control the amount of the resources that are given in terms of the processor. So with processors, there's 2 aspects. There's the logical aspect, meaning this machine has 8 individual cores, so it's got 8 physical cores, and then the virtual aspect. So that's the virtual CPUs. And CPUs, in this case, are basically just a pool of resources. It's just a pool of what appears to be a CPU, but may not really correspond to a physical CPU. So for Active Directory, you know, we've got 2 CPUs. We really need Active Directory to be on. So I'm going to reserve 50% of this environment, right? So now we're getting 12% of the total system resources applied to this virtual machine. And then the virtual machine limit, we're going to leave that at 100%. And then, but we're going to bring its relative weight down a little bit. In other words, its weight relative to the other virtual machines with those processors, because we've now basically set out of 2 processors, we're going to give it 1 physical processor, but compared to say the database or the front end, we don't really need it to be that heavy. The front end is the critical piece, right? If the web front end goes down or slows down because it doesn't have the right resources, then you've really got problems. Now your customers will be upset. So we're going to limit Active Directory to a fairly large degree. Okay, so if you get those, now we can start looking at some of these others. Well, the web front end, you know, it definitely needs to start up, and 2 gigabytes to start, I mean, because this machine is limited, we're dealing with numbers that are somewhat small, But, you know, 2 gigabytes to get this thing started is probably pretty good. And then we've enabled dynamic memory and then given it 64 megabytes of absolute minimum RAM. So this would be the minimum that it would fall back to. It probably won't. Let's put that to 128 so it just has some memory to work from in the beginning. And then we're going to max it out at 5 gigabytes. And then the buffer, well, you know, for the web front end, a buffer of 20% is probably pretty good. And then if we want to give it more weight, because the website is critical, so the web front end is critical to the business or to the environment, so we're gonna give that a higher priority for the availability of memory. And then the number of virtual processors is 2. Because it's so critical, let's bump that to 4. So we've got plenty of processor power on the front end. And again, that's virtual processor. So you're just taking 4 out of the pool. You can assign 4 or more to the other systems as well. And then I want to reserve, because there's 4, I want definitely at least one processor, one physical processor to be associated with the web front ends. 25% is one physical processor. And then the virtual machine limit percentage, we're just going to let it run there. And so the front end can now get 50% of the total system resources, and I want its relative weight be 120, so that it has a higher weight than the ones that are at 100. And we'll just go ahead and apply that. And then the mid-tier, talked about that a little bit. Let's go to its settings. And it's got 2 virtual processors. I think I'm going to bring that, again, because this is probably a little bit CPU heavy, we're going to bring that to 4. And in this case, we're going to reserve 50%, because we always, you know, the mid-tier is going to be a resource hog. And then we'll leave the virtual machine limit to 100%, so it now gets 50% of total system resources, and leave its relative weight at 100. Now the database. For memory, the database definitely has to get more memory. And we've got dynamic memory enabled, minimum RAM. This is, you know, it's just going to settle down to whatever it wants to, and it may never reach that minimum. But in terms of the maximum, we want to give it 12 gigabytes of memory. We know it's going to need a lot of memory, and then we'll leave its memory weight alone. And then in terms of processors, we're going to give it 6 processors, because people are going to be doing analytics on it, and that's what we need. So in terms of reserve, the database needs some degree of reserve. So I'm just going to say 10% of the virtual machine reserve, and that gives it 7% of the total resources. And then we're just going to leave it alone in terms of the virtual machine limit and in terms of the relative weight, and apply those. So we've given this machine a lot of settings. Why don't we now go ahead and start them up, see what happens. As they're starting, you can see the amount of memory that has been assigned for them to start with. And we've got this pretty good. In other words, there's not a lot of free memory, but there's a little bit of a buffer of free memory, almost 2 gigabytes. And then the standby is the allocated memory from what we requested to be the buffer. All of this is the memory that's currently in use because it's been assigned here, but it will actually drop down as these systems start to moderate. In other words, they're not going to continue to use all of this memory. And that was just to show you how the systems have settled down into the amount of memory that they require at a minimum. So if we now look over here at what's happening with memory in use, is a little bit over 4 gigabytes, right? And then you've got the standby, which is from all of the reservations we made, and then a lot more free memory. So hopefully you can see how that happens. You have a particular startup memory, a setting for processors as well, and the system will use all of that memory to do startup, but then once it settles down, it goes into the dynamic memory and it modifies the amount of memory that is operating with. I hope this information on CPU settings and memory settings in Hyper-V will be useful to you. So thank you very much for watching.